Hello and welcome to Intriguing Realms. This is a true story set in northern Cyprus in the 1990s. It serves as a reminder to respect people's personal space. So settle back, dim the lights, and listen to a story we call The Soldier. I was teaching at a university in Lefke, a small town that had suffered greatly during the 1974 war between the Greeks and the Turks. The new university had brought new life to the area. The locals cashed in on the influx of students by renting out their old dilapidated family homes, whilst withdrawing to more modern apartments. One of my students, Kamal, and his sister Melda, had decided to rent one of these houses. It was a beautiful old Ottoman townhouse, dating back at least a century. Although verging on dereliction, it had an old-world charm, with large, drafty rooms, creaking floorboards, and crumbling plaster walls. The elderly landlady showed them around the house, reciting a list of house rules as she went. On the ground floor, she gestured towards one of the doors and explained that the room was to always remain locked and off limits. She did not elaborate further and moved on with the tour. Over the coming weeks, the students became aware that the locals were giving them strange looks as they entered the house. On one occasion, when Kamal was in the local shop, he mentioned where he was living. The shopkeeper asked him to wait while he finished serving a couple of customers and gestured for him to pull up a chair. Over a couple of glasses of hot, sweet Turkish tea, he told Kamal the whole story. The story started in 1974 during the war. There had been fighting between the Greeks and Turks in the town, and a Greek soldier had taken refuge in the house. A group of Turkish soldiers had followed him there, and after a shootout, he was killed inside the house. Over the following 20 years, rumors had abounded that strange things were happening in the house, especially in the room where the soldier had been killed. Eventually, the landlady and her son had moved out of the house and into their new apartment, leaving the house to fall into ruin. Later that evening, Melda was cleaning the house. Inside one of the storerooms, she noticed a small key hanging on a nail just inside the door. She knew at once which door it would open. She fleetingly considered having a look inside the locked room, but was distracted by the arrival of three friends. When Kamal returned, he excitedly shared with the group what the shopkeeper had told him. A debate started about whether or not to have a peek inside the room now that they had the key. Eagerly, the boys agreed, if only to have the opportunity to frighten the girls. Melda turned the key in the lock with a nervous hand. It opened smoothly, and she reached inside to find the light switch. The light didn't work. The group all peered inside from the threshold, not daring to enter. The room was nearly pitch black, with only a trickle of light from around the edges of the wooden shutters. No furniture, just bare boards and cobwebs. Silence. Minutes passed, and then suddenly, just the faintest noise like a floorboard being walked upon. The girls screamed, and the door was slammed shut and hurriedly locked again. That night, Melda awoke at 3 a.m. Someone was speaking in a low, deep voice, almost a whisper. It was like hearing one side of a conversation on a phone. She thought perhaps Kamal was talking to their parents back in Istanbul. She strained to hear and slowly realized that she didn't understand the words. It was Greek. She sat up in bed. The room was almost pitch black. Then she noticed, in the corner of the room, a pinprick of light like a firefly. It moved slowly across the room towards her, and its outline shimmered as its size fluctuated. There was no bedside lamp, and to reach the light switch meant crossing the room. So she pulled the bedsheets up around her neck and closed her eyes tightly. Then she had the strangest feeling someone was looking at her. A presence in the room. The more scared she became, the less she dared to open her eyes. She opened them the merest crack. There was a shadow falling across her face. She opened her eyes. A face with sad, desperate eyes was there for a split second, and then it was gone. Kamal and Melda left the house the next day and never returned. 10 years later, I returned to Lefke and drove past the house. It was more or less completely derelict. The roof had collapsed and the lower floor windows were all boarded up. I couldn't help thinking that perhaps the Greek soldier still resided there, alone and finally undisturbed. If you have had a true supernatural experience, please send it to us at IntriguingRealms@gmail.com and we may feature it on the channel. Join us next time and don't forget to like and subscribe. We publish new content weekly. Sweet dreams.